Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Okay, we are from group 12. On this occasion, we will explain about the result of our assignment. The assignment is analysis of a journal article on linguistics. Well, I will read the identity of the article that we use. The title is Identity and Interaction, a Sociocultural Linguistic Approach. The authors, Takuts, Mary, Hall, Kira. The journal Discourse Studies, volume and year 7 and 2005. And link you can see on the PowerPoint. Okay, before going further to this article, I will introduce our member. First, I am Asih Hovifa, and then Nugraheni Alatif, and the last, Lisa Arifatul Fajri. Okay, I will read about the content on this presentation. First, about research background. Second, about theory. Third, about results, methodology. And last, about result or finding. Okay, about research background will be delivered by me. The author's purpose, a framework for the analysis of identity as constituted in linguistic interaction. The need for such a framework has become apparent in the recent years, as linguistic research on identity has become increasingly central within sociolinguistics, linguistic anthropology, discourse analysis, and social psychology. But the concomitant development of theoretical approaches to identity remains at best a secondary concern, not a focus goal of the field. Okay, second about theory. In this article, use many theory. First by Giles et al. 1991. About social identity theory, Meyerhold. 1996, Meyerhoff and Nedelsky. 1994, Tavel and Turner. 1979, and social psychology theories of language ideology, Irwin and Gall. 2000, Silverstein. 1979, and indexicality, Ox. 1992, Silverstein. 1976, in linguistic anthropology and theories of style, Eckhart and Bickford. 2001, Melissa Denton. 2002. And models of identity, Lippitt and Taborit Keller, 1985, in sociolinguistics, among others. That's all for me. Thanks for your attention. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Here Elisa Ifatubaji. I will explain about research methodology. The type of this article is qualitative, and subject is people who want to know about linguistic. And the next object is sociocultural linguistic. And what is the research design by use in connecting the researcher? It may include approaching the researcher purpose here, which has insight from various fields and theories. In addition, research in several fields has informed our own views about identity. The work included speech exercise and so on. Okay, and the next is, in this article, we propose a framework for the analysis of identity as from linguistic interaction. In addition, researchers also use method with the development of the theoretical approach to identity remains a secondary concern, not a goal focused on the ground. And the researchers debate the analytic value of the identity approach as relational and sociocultural and cultural phenomena that arise and circulate in the context of local discourse. And the framework with outline here synthesize a key work on identity from oldest traditions to offer a general sociocultural linguistic perspective on identity that is the one is focused on both the detail of language and the workings of culture and society. And by sociocultural linguistic, we mean the broad interdisciplinary field concerned with the intersection of language, culture, and society. And this term encompasses the disciplinary subfield of sociolinguistic, linguistic anthropology, social oriented form of discourse analysis such as conversation analysis and critical discourse analysis, and the last linguistically oriented social and psychology, among other. The first is in incorporating these diverse approaches under a single label. Our purpose is neither to deny the difference among them, nor to impose new disciplinary boundaries. Rather, it is to acknowledge the full range of work that falls under the rubric of language and identity, and to offer a shorthand device for referring to these approaches collectively. And the interdisciplinary perspective taken here is intended to help scholars recognize the comprehensive already available to them for analyzing identity as a central linguistic phenomenon. And as our example below illustrate, identity does not emerge at single and analytic level, whether for quality, concept, code choice, or ideological structure, about operate at multiple levels simultaneously, and research abroad privilege the interactional level because it is in interaction that all these researches gain social meaning. The researcher goals is to assemble elements of socio-cultural linguistic work on identity into a coherent model that both describes the current state of research and offer a new direction for a future scholarship. And this chart proposed 5 principles that was fundamental to the study of identity. Using the 5 principles, we see as the basis for the study of identity, the first and the second principle challenges the narrow psychological and static view of identity that has been widely circulated in the the social sciences. Researcher argument instead in line with the abundant sociocultural linguistic research, identity is this discursive instruct that arises in the interaction. And furthermore, the researcher explained the traditional macro-sociological view of identity to include local ethnographic categories and temporary interactional position. The third principle is a macro and inventory of spaces linguistic research in which the actor of the interaction index position themselves and other in lecture. The essence of the model is explained in the fourth principle, which highlights the relational basis of identity. To illustrate the principle, we briefly outline our newly developed framework for analyzing identity as intersubjective assessment. And finally, the fifth principle considers limitation and constraints on individual intentionality and the process of identity construction, while not knowledge the important role that intentional social action may play in generating identity. And throughout the article, the researcher debates the view on identity intersubjective rather than individually produced and interactional appear rather than saging appearing. Okay, jadi dalam artikel ini kami mengusulkan kerangka kerja untuk analisis identitas seperti yang terbentuk di linguistik. Dan selain itu, peneliti juga menggunakan metode dengan pengembangan pendekatan teoritis terhadap identitas tetap menjadi perhatian sekunder, bukan tujuan yang berfokus pada peneliti tersebut. Kemudian peneliti mendebatkan nilai analitik dari pendekatan identitas sebagai rasional dan sosio-kultural, fenomena budaya yang muncul dan beredar dalam konteks wacana lokal. Kemudian kerangka kerja yang kami uraikan di sini yaitu mensintesis pekerjaan utama pada identitas dari semua ini tadi untuk menawarkan perspektif linguistik sosio-kultural umum tentang identitas, yaitu yang berfokus pada detail bahasa dan cara kerja budaya dan masyarakat. Oleh linguistik sosio-kultural, yang kami maksud ini adalah bidang interdisipliner yang luas yang berkaitan dengan pertemuan antara bahasa, budaya, dan masyarakat. Dari istilah inilah mencakup disiplin sebidang sosiolinguistik, antropologi, linguistik, bentuk wacana yang berorientasi sosial analisis seperti analisis percakapan dan analisis wacana kritis. Dan secara linguistik berorientasi psikologi sosial yang mencakup, yang pertama itu ada dalam menggabungkan pendekatan yang beragam di bawah tabel tunggal yang bertujuan bukan untuk menyangkal perbedaan di antara mereka atau memaksakan yang baru. Kemudian batas-batas disiplin alih-alih itu adalah untuk mengakui berbagai pekerjaan yang berada di bawah rubrik bahasa dan identitas untuk menawarkan perangkat singkatan untuk merujuk ke pendekatan secara kolektif. Kemudian perspektif interdisipliner yang diambil saat ini yaitu dimaksudkan untuk membantu para sarjana menggali perangkat komprehensif yang sudah tersedia bagi mereka, yaitu untuk menganalisis identitas sebagai fenomena linguistik sentral, yang mana seperti diilustrasikan oleh contoh kami di bawah ini, yaitu identitas tidak muncul pada tingkat analitik tunggal yang apakah kualitas vokal, bentuk giliran, pilihan kode, atau ideostruktur logis, tapi beroperasi pada beberapa level secara bersamaan. Kemudian pendekatan penelitian mengutamakan tingkat interaksional karena dalam interaksi semua sumber daya ini yaitu memperoleh keuntungan sosial. Terus kemudian tujuan dari penelitian ini adalah untuk merangkai unsur-unsur karya linguistik sosiokultural tentang identitas menjadi model koheren yang menggambarkan keadaan penelitian saat ini dan menawarkan arah untuk beasiswa masa depan. Kemudian peneliti mengusulkan 5 prinsip yang mendasar untuk studi identitas, yaitu menggunakan 5 prinsip yang kita lihat sebagai dasar untuk studi identitas. Yang pertama dan kedua itu menantang pandangan psikologis dan statis yang sempit tentang identitas. Dan penelitian linguistik sosiokultural yang melimpah, identitas adalah konstruksi diskursif yang muncul dalam interaksi. Selanjutnya, peneliti memperluas sosiologi makro tradisional, yaitu pandangan identitas untuk memasukkan kategori etnografi, lokal, dan posisi interaksional sementara. Kemudian prinsip ketiga adalah membuat inventarisasi sumber daya linguistik spesies di mana para aktor indeks interaksi memposisikan diri dan orang lain dalam perkuliahan. Kemudian inti dari model yang didasarkan dalam prinsip keempat tersebut yaitu yang menyoroti dasar rasional identitas. Kemudian dalam mengilustrasikan prinsip ini, kami secara tingkat menguraikan kerangka kerja kami yang baru, yaitu dikembangkan untuk menganalisis identitas sebagai pencapaian intersubjektif, yang mana akhirnya prinsip kelima itu mempertimbangkan keterbatasan dan kendala pada intensionalitas individu dalam proses konstruksi identitas, sedangkan mengakui peran penting yang mungkin dimainkan oleh tindakan sosial yang disengaja itu dalam menghasilkan identitas. Namun sepanjang artikel, peneliti ini mendapatkan pandangan tentang identitas intersubjektif daripada produksi secara individual dan interaksional muncul daripada yang ditugaskan a priori. I think that's enough for me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon guys. How is it going? I hope you are in a good condition, okay? My name is Nugrehina Latif. Here I will continue the material about result or finding. There are several principles described, namely the first principle that inform our perspective of discussing the traditional scientific view of identity as being placed primarily in the mind of the individual, so that the only possible relationship between identity and language use is for language to be reflected in the individual's internal mental state. Moreover, in functional and interactional linguistics, we extend insight from previous linguistic work on this emergency to identity and lies. As with performance, culture, and grammar itself, we maintain that identity arises from the special condition of linguistic interaction. Identity is seen as an emerging product rather than a pre-existing one. Sorts of other linguistic and semiotic practices, and therefore a social and cultural phenomenon. This is familiar idea in several very different socio-cultural branches of linguistics. The ethno-methodological concept of doing different and more general types of identities, the semiotic concept of creative identicality, and arbitration of discern. Despite the fundamental differences between the approach, they all allow us to view identity as more than just a psychological mechanism. Self-classification, which is reflected in people's social behavior, but as something that is formed through social action and especially of language. Of course, the nature of emergency does not exclude the possibility that the resort for identity at work in a given interaction may come from resorts developed in previous interaction. The second principle challenges another widely circulated view of identity. That is simply a collection of broad social categories. This perspective is most often found in quantitative social science, which relates social behavior to macro-identity categories such as age, gender, and social class. Identity relations emerge in interaction through several indexical processes, including A. The open mention of categories and identity labels. B. Implied tests and presupposition about the identity position of oneself or others. C. Demonstrate an evaluative and epistemic orientation toward the ongoing conversation, as well as the foothold for action and the role of the participant. And D. The use of linguistic structure and system that are ideologically related to particular persons and groups. And then the next is principle of rationality. The first three principles we have discussed focus on the emergency, positional, and indexical aspect of identity and its production. Building on this point, the fourth principle emphasizes identity as a relational phenomenon. In calling attention to rationality, we have to aim first to underscore the point that identity is never autonomous or independent, but always acquires a social identity of meaning in relation to other available identity position and other social actors. And the second is questioning the widespread but of simple view of the relationship of identity as revolving around a single axis, similarity and difference. And the next material is about availability and difference. The first two complementary identity relationship that we describe, similarities and difference, are also the ones most discussed in socio-scientific research on identity. To highlight the way we depart from this traditional view of relationship, we use the term adequacy and difference. The term adequacy emphasizes the fact that in order for group or individual to be positioned as equal, they need not and in any case cannot be identical, but must only be understood as similar enough for inter-objective action. Thus, differences that are irrelevant or undermining the ongoing effort of two people or groups will be underestimated, and similarities seen as salient and in favor of direct project or identify work will be at the fore. And the next is authentication and denaturization. The second pair of relationship, authentication and denaturalization, is the process by which the speaker makes claim to reality and intelligence, respectively, while both relationship have to do with authenticity. The first focus on the ways in which discursive identities are verified, and the second on how assumption regarding the subtlety of identity can be destroyed. Like a focus on difference, attention to authenticity. That is, what kind of language and language user are considered native for a given purpose, has permeated the sociocultural linguistic literature, although analyzed do not always support their own assumption about authenticity from the speaker they study. And the last material is about authorization and elegization, the final pairs of intersubjective relationships. that we describe consider the structural and institutional aspect of identity formation. The first of this, authorization, involves the affirmation or imposition of identity through institutionalized power structures and ideologies, both local and translocal. The principle of partisanship, the latter principle, draws on the extensive literature in cultural anthropology and feminist theory over the past two decades that has challenged the analytic drive to represent forms of social life as internally coherent. Maybe enough for me. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.